All rise.
Oh. What up, what up? What's up? Tom MacDonald, you found yourself in my courtroom again. Public defendants on this case. Hashtag hangover game for life. Yo, Tom MacDonald, you find yourself in my courtroom once again, also after appearing on Fake Woke. Now, we've heard that court case, so guess what? This is your appeals case. You entered a plea of not innocent for record microphones for a long time independently. You don't care what people think. So, how do we do it? You already know. Right hand on the mic, left hand in the air. Do you swear to spit the lyrics, the whole lyrics, and nothing but the lyrics, and kill this beat with your bars? We'll step into the booth then. Appeals begins now. Bars. Yo, what up? It's your boy, LeCain. Let's dap it up. Bars. But now your face that makes you famous, Tom MacDonald. And your face been all over the news lately as well. Fake Woke, got a lot of people talking, got a lot of discussion, got my jury deliberating all dang week. We're here for it. So, here's how we gonna do it. All right, in the Hip Hop Court of Law, case number 436.1, we got canceled. Oh, jury members, you ready to deliberate again? Because that's exactly what we're about to do. You think I want to hear this case? Think I want to hear it today? This bomb that he drops in my courtroom? Well, we're going to do it. So how do we judge it? Bars, flow, message, crime scene, the video. And boy, do we got a crime scene. The bar scheme bear, the court of owls, they're on Zoom. I'm the judge. You're the jury. Let's go.
I can't be canceled, there's no way that you can stop me. I'm fully independent, there's no label who can drop me.
Now, this is one of the things. As many people want to sit here and criticize Tom for, he's whack, he's trash, he's this, he's whatever. He's independent. You cannot stop him. He's going to drop whatever the heck he wants to drop, however he wants to drop it. That's a bar. Next, cancel culture. When in America have we become, not we, some of us, some people, have become so weak? You want to cancel everybody from rappers to entertainers to YouTube people to celebrities to whoever you want to cancel. Let's talk about the beat. I love the way this beat's coming in, more like a chorus, a seance. The beat, he's basically, lyrically, giving you that type of scripture, like, I'm going to speak my peace. The beat starts off with a very hollow, think of The Undertaker, the ministry, how he used to come in kind of like with that chorus, that dark, methodical type of beat. This is how this is coming off. Let's go, Tom, let's go.
Y'all been starting rumors, let me help you with some. Yeah.
He's a racist, he's a sexist, he's in love with Donald Trump.
Now, this whole thing, we're breaking it all the way down. You know how I do it. So, he's a racist. Tom MacDonald, from what I know, from what I hear, from what I see, is far from a racist. From what I know. Unless somebody could bring to my courtroom something different, Tom ain't that. In love with Donald Trump or whatever. Tom MacDonald speaks his mind on how he wants to speak it, which we all should. We want to speak our mind, that's fine. Once again, we face the backlash of cancel culture. Cancel culture, the people who want to come out. Once again, it's opinions. He want to speak his opinion just like anybody could speak their opinion. They're going to speak their opinion. My opinion is my opinion. So, like, if I say something in my courtroom, and especially when we're deliberating with the jury members, and if you guys have known, I've been deliberating with y'all all week in the jury room. I walk my line. I speak my opinion. That's what Tom is saying. Can't cancel me. I am who I am. Come on, let's go.
He's a racist. He's a sexist. He's in love with Donald Trump. Yep.
Now, think of that last line he said on Fake Woke. He's a sexist because he talked about feminism. Well, I'm going to assume Nova his co-defendant is not going to be with him if he's a sexist. I'm going to assume he's not. He speaks his mind. Tom MacDonald's the type of person who speaks his mind and makes his songs off of what he feels, what he sees in the world. So if you want to cancel somebody for speaking their mind, then that's a problem. Cancel culture has been around for years. It's always been around. It's just more prevalent now because it's so out there. You disagree with somebody, you want to cancel them. For what? If you don't agree, don't agree. Simple. But have a discussion about it.
Y'all can't cancel me. My life is scandal free. There ain't no sponsors taking losses because the brand is me. My hands are clean.
That's what I'm saying. I'm my own man. Ain't no sponsors taking losses. So whatever I say is not going to lose no corporation money. I'm saying it. I can only lose my money. I'm the brand. Just like me, the courtroom. Face Famous is the brand. Ain't no sponsors here. I can say whatever the hell I want to say, and people either going to deal with it or not. You can unsubscribe or subscribe based on what I say. But everybody is their own brand, essentially, to be honest. If you don't have a sponsor, you're your brand. You ain't worried about taking losses except taking losses for yourself based on your actions, what you say, and what you do. So you always have to be mindful of that as well. If you want to say things that could be deemed controversial, what can you lose? You could lose your job. You could lose. You could be out of a team sport. You can, hell, lose your kids. You can lose some rights. You could be arrested. You could be whatever. Freedom of speech. You could say whatever you want. But that doesn't mean it's freedom of consequence. It's what he's saying. I'm the brand. I have that freedom of consequence because of my freedom of speech. I don't have sponsors, but he is wise enough to know there is still freedom of consequence. So that's what he's saying. Because Tom,
why are you so extra?
He gotta be that way because he is who he is.
Family and my fans agree. Y'all can't cancel me for facts because you're mad and weak. Go ahead and tell the world I'm ugly and racist.
Feel that guitar riff. Also feel the uptick in his voice. So now the bars, the flow is coming in. The guitar riff is now he's going second level. So just like a movie, beginning, middle, end. He's about to start reaching his storyline before he hits the climax. So, go ahead, Tom, let's go.
Bad and weak. Go ahead and tell the world I'm ugly and racist. I braid my hair and I don't care about cultural appropriation. I moved to the ghetto. Lived in the ghetto. There's no Caucasians. Hair and not.
Listen to how he's saying. He's about to explain himself. Evidence A, let's go.
I don't care about cultural appropriation. I moved to the ghetto, lived in the ghetto. There's no Caucasians, and still I loved every single one of my neighbors. How's a man say I'm clickbait if he gonna use this face to get clicks on his page? Y'all hypocrites are made.
Yeah, some of y'all are straight bitch made. So, clickbait. Let me explain what clickbait is. If it gets you to click, it was bait. If you go fishing and you put bait on a fishing pole, you catch a shark. That was some damn good bait. Tom MacDonald's the shark. Eminem's a shark. Tupac's a shark. Cardi B is a shark. You sit there and you click on it because if somebody puts that in the title, was that a diss towards M? Was that a diss towards Cardi B? She ain't a role model. She is not good for the kids. Is it clickbait if you say you don't like a certain president, whether it be Trump, whether it be Biden, whether it be Clinton, whether it be Bush? Clickbait. If it's a good thing, hey, such and such celebrity had a baby, you're going to click on it. Clickbait. That title got you to click. It's bait. If I catch a shark, good bait. If I catch a trout, good bait. If I catch nothing, well, your title sucked. Wasn't clickbait. Don't use Tom's face and then say, oh, yeah, you're going to use that face to get views because he said X, Y, Z. But then be mad, but then you go do it. Clickbait. You want to use his face. Come on, man. Tell him, Tom. Let's go.
I use this face to get clicks on his page. Y'all hypocrites are made. But I ain't tripping about these bullies. It ain't sixth grade. Go ahead and diss me trying to sell a couple mixtapes.
How you gonna do it? How you gonna do it? So that's the thing. You want to diss him, you know what? If I'm a rapper and I diss Tom, I'm gonna get a couple album sales because I use his name to make them sales. But while that is being said, you ain't getting rid of me. It's clickbait. Once again, he's using the whole clickbait scheme. And I like his cadence. So we'll go to the cadence. The cadence is nice. He's basically speaking and rapping at the same time expressing his thoughts. He's basically saying, hey, you want to use my name for clickbait titles? You're using it to sell mixtapes. You're using my name for something. But you're crying about clickbait because you clicked on something that wasn't what you thought it was going to be. Hey, that was clickbait. I'm unsubbing or I don't like the video or whatever. But you clicked on it. It worked. If you're not using clickbait, something's wrong with you. You got to use something in the title. But you go turn around and do the same thing. Tom is on fire, man. Come on, let's go.
Man, but I ain't tripping about these bullies. It ain't sixth grade. Go ahead and diss me trying to sell a couple mixtapes. I'm not afraid. Take my face and my name. Paste it on the front page. I'm already famous and you'll never change it by hating or claiming you'll take it away.
Now, I'm taking the beat. The cadence switch. So that's a different cadence switch. Now he's basically on spit how it is. This is what I'm about to say to it. I gave you the intro to the story. Boom, dun, dun, dun. Chapter one is this. Chapter one, verse one is this. Just like a Bible. Chapter one, verse one. We about to catch some fire. Let's go.
Couple mixtapes. I'm not afraid. Take my face and my name. Paste it on the front page. I'm already famous and you'll never change it by hating or claiming you'll take it away.
Like he's saying, how you gonna take it away? I'm already famous. I got money. I don't even have to do this if I don't want to do it. So take my face. Use whatever you got to use to get your views and whatever you got to use to make your money. Go ahead. I ain't afraid. This ain't sixth grade. You can't bully me. I ain't scared of you thugs. How you gonna sit there? Y'all internet thugs gonna sit here and try to punk me. It ain't gonna happen. I'm already rich. I'm independent. What are you gonna do? I don't care. I'm Tom. You can hate me, love me, but guess what? You hate me, you still click. You want to hate and use my face, you still click just to make album sales. You like me? Click. You don't like me? Hey, I'm paid. That's basically what you're saying. I'm getting money regardless.
Mixtapes. I'm not afraid. Take my face and my name. Paste it on the front page. I'm already famous and you'll never change it by hating or claiming you'll take it away. My grind wicked, write my rhymes different. You could try to quantify defying limits as a dying gimmick and denying winning. This is pure fire. This ain't white privilege.
They said, this ain't white privilege. I've been broke. I've been in the ghetto. I twisted my hair. There's no white people around, but I loved all my neighbors. So this goes back to what he's saying. This ain't white privilege. I did this on my own. Me, my wife. Girlfriend, if he's married, I think it's his girlfriend. We may say wife, but he's, I did this on my own. How are you going to stop what I created? Do whatever you got to do. Take this fit. Do. Hey, do you? I'm rich, though. I built this by myself. This ain't white privilege. Nobody gave me a handout. So what he's saying is you can't give me a handout when I already built it myself. I have no sponsors to lose. I'm my only thing going. I'm making this on my own. So you can't cry. You can't cry, oh, well, you white privilege. Can't do that. Not with this cat.
Wait, my grind wicked, write my rhymes different. You could try to quantify defying limits as a dying gimmick and denying winning. This is pure fire. This ain't white privilege. I do what I want. Get all the Gucci and Louis Vuitton out of my closet, out of my crib. I do not want it. That is for kids. That is for rappers who ask you to produce their beats for free, pretending online like they rich. I am not playing it safe. I said what I said. It is what it is. I don't care if you
I love that part. Like you said, I could buy whatever I want. I don't want it. That's why all them rappers say, hey, make my beats for free. You think you Louis Vuitton, all that stuff don't impress me. I say what I want. I'm seeing the world how I want to see it, and I'm spitting it pure fire. You getting it how you want it. You want smoke? Then you're going to get it. So
why you so extra?
That's what he's saying. What you gonna do to take it away from me? How you gonna take away from me? Huh? But if you want to go there,
you don't want that smoke.
We got something for you, Tom. That's for them kids. Tell
them. Me, okay. Go ahead and change the channel.
Change the channel. So why click on something you hate? If I don't like it, it's like watching the movie. If I don't like a movie, I'm clicking off. If I don't like a TV show, I'm clicking off. If I don't like a YouTube video, I'm clicking off of it. The chorus, I'm loving this chorus. Tom, in a lot of people's eyes, is not known for having the best choruses for some people. Some people are turned off by his choruses. This, I'm feeling it. The guitar riff, the uptick in beat, the uptick in tempo, not to mention how he's singing on this hook. Hey, you can try to cancel him. Let's go.
I don't care if you mad at me, okay? Go ahead and change the channel.
As the verse goes, he added more and more instruments to it. So that sing song hook is like a whole nother story. You could try to cancel, like he's saying, I dare you. Go ahead, bring it, change the channel. I'm still going to do what I'm going to do. It doesn't change who I am. Just like whether it's reactors, just like whether it's entertainers, if you have that certain thing about you, like me, I'm the same way. I'll dialogue with y'all in the comments all day long. Sometimes I want to snap on people, but I still have to think it through. What am I going to say? Because I want to say things in a logical way. I want to make sure you understand where I'm coming from. So when I dialogue with you jury members, I want to make sure that's how we're going to do it. All right, let's go.
No wasting time trying to cancel me. They love me because they know that I'm it. Say what you want, I guess it is what it is. Haters can talk, but they can't cancel the kid. Go ahead and go on.
Like you say what you want, guess it is what it is. I said what I said. How you going? You can't take that away. It goes back to the whole freedom of speech. Once again, not freedom of consequence, but is speech really free? Think about it. Is it really free? Is in this country, is it? You could say it is. I mean, it's freedom of speech. You could go all day long. I could say what I want. It's freedom of speech. Once again, freedom of consequence. So not really free. Other countries, you have freedom of speech. They have a freedom to take your life in other countries. Our country are better at freedom of speech than others. But is it really free when they're trying to cancel you for everything you're trying to say? If I don't agree with what this person says, I'm going to cancel them. No, I'm just not going to listen to them. Well, I may listen and be dismissive of it. I'm not going to try to cancel you. You have the freedom to say whatever you want. You have the freedom to insult me if you want to. You have a freedom to insult anybody. They have a freedom to insult you back. So don't get mad. Once again, if you dish it, you better be able to take it. Don't get mad like I'm going to cancel them or I don't like what they said on Twitter, on Facebook, or this person I thought was a Christian and they end up being an atheist. Or this person liked the Raiders, but they end up liking the Chiefs. They like the Cowboys, but now they like the Panthers. I'm canceling. F them. They shouldn't wear that hat. I ain't never buying another one again. My favorite athlete or my favorite artist, my favorite entertainer said this. I don't agree with that. I'm canceling. Quit being weak. Deal with it.
I'll try and say this is it, but I swear to God, you can't cancel the kid. Everybody knows my name from local folks to global fame. I'm vocal.
Now, let's talk the metaphor of the video. He was in a cage. Like I said, they're trying to box him into the cage with the red around him. So he's under security. Got him locked down in the cage under security. Now he has a white shirt with the dots on him. So now it's like, hey, we coming for you. So it's one of the situations now that he's saying, you want to cancel me? Now you got the red dot on him. Now you want to take me out. Can you do it? It's the kill shots in the military. We got the red dot. Who's going to take that shot? But who's going to make that shot? Let's go.
About the social justice movements, I expose the fakes, turn rappers into ghosts.
Now, let's talk about the social justice movement. Like you said, he exposed the fakes. I want to say this about every last group out there, and let me make myself very, very clear. I don't care if it's BLM. I don't care if it's Antifa. I don't care if it's the Proud Boys. I don't care if it's the Black Panthers. I don't care if it's the NAACP, NCAA, NFL. I don't care what group is out there. It's not for me to decide how they should be and what they should be. There's some fake ones in all of them. Pretty simple. Every group got some fake people in there. He exposed the fakes. My opinion is there's fake ones all over. Now, it's nice learning about all them groups. I really like to learn about them because I don't know who's who, like I said before. who's who, who's going to do what, who's doing what, who's for and against, who's pro and con, X, Y, Z. I don't care. I just want to learn. Y'all know more about them than me. I don't get into depth trying to study all these people. I just have an opinion. I just have what I say. And like Tom said, there's some fakes. I can see that for myself. Just watching the news, whatever channel, I don't care what channel it is. I can see there's some fake ones out there. Pretty simple. You know, that's just how it is. Like I said, I've been talking to y'all in the comments, and some of this, I'm just going to say it. I need to be more clear in my position. They're just opinions, just how I feel, just like you have how you feel, and I talk to y'all about it. I want to make sure. Tom is saying the same thing. I'm just more blunt about it, as Tom is saying. Tom is saying I'm more blunt. I'm exposed to everybody. I don't care how you're going to take me out. I'm independent. You can't beat me in this game. That's what he's saying.
Folks, to global fame, I'm vocal about the social justice movements. I expose the fakes, turn rappers into ghosts and graves. Make no mistake, they bones will break. I'll throw them in the wolf enclosure, slowly turn and close the cage. Acres full of sheep, you know that I'm the only goat. I'm great, they spoke my name.
Acres full of sheep, you know I'm the only goat. I'm great. Hey, did you know goat is some of the most intelligent and independent people? Well, not independent people, well, ghosts as in rappers, but ghosts as the animals, some of the most intelligent, independent animals out there. So in a room, in a whole yard full of sheep, following orders, trying to fit in, trying to be. He's like, I'm intelligent. I'm independent. I'm the goat. I'm great. I'm exposed to these rappers as well. You bring it? You want that smoke? Bring it. What you gonna do? Gonna get tore up around here? Tell us how I'll F you up quickly.
Those the fakes turn rappers into ghosts and graves. Make no mistake, they bones will break. I'll throw them in the wolf enclosure, slowly turn and close the cage. That? Acres full of
how about that?
The sheep, you know that I'm the only goat. I'm great. They spoke my name to mostly hate. I don't complain. I'm woke. I wait. I total focus.
Like I said, I don't complain. I'm woke. I wait. I turn out
acres full of sheep, you know that I'm the only goat. I'm great, they spoke my name to mostly hate. I don't complain, I'm woke, I wait. A total focus soldier, wrote the art of war. Know every page, I'm numb to all the dumbness. Smoke tobacco laced with Novocaine. I won't
Novocaine, shout out to Nova. Hey, he studied the art of war. I read the art of war. I read the 48 powers of law. I read the 50th law. I read the 33 strategies of war. Robert Greene, if you don't know. 50th law, 50 cent, Robert Greene. But once again, like you say, you study those things, you study tactics. Like you said, what you gonna do? I know the art of war. I know what you're gonna say. I know what you're gonna do. I'm already 5, 6, 10 steps ahead of you. I knew before I dropped this video, Tom MacDonald, I knew before I dropped this video, I'm gonna get hate. That's what Tom is saying. I'm gonna get hate. I already knew. You want to speak my name? You want to hate? You want to invoke my name just to hate? Go ahead. Whatever. It don't bother me. Novocaine. It could be a shout out to his wife, Novocaine. Nova. And like you said, I'm smoking cigarettes laced with Novocaine. I'm numb to the bull. My mouth is numb. I don't care. You can't hurt me. What you going to say? Like me or not, I'm always going to be me.
Don't behave. I stoke the flames. I'll choke their throats with golden chains. Use vocal.
Oh, I love that overlay in his voice. You hear that overlay? So now he's back to the preaching. So we're about to go into chapter 2. But that overlay in his voice, that dub, I like the overlay because it gave it a more demonic, sinister tone. I'm feeling that.
Page, I'm numb to all the dumbness. Smoke tobacco laced with Novocaine. I won't behave. I stoke the flames. I'll choke.
Back to the guitar riff.
They throats with golden chains, use vocal cords as skipping ropes and jump till I am soaked in brains from open plains to coastal waves to solar rays in open space. Can't find nobody doper unless you poke your veins and snort cocaine.
Blowing it up. You say you ain't gonna find it. Tom is on his stuff. He's basically answering all the critics from when he dropped the last song, was on Fox, and now he comes back with this. He's like, guess what? I got something else to say.
Y'all can't cancel me. Just get mad that I'm the man until you smash the screen. Like, whoa, I can handle heat. I walk through hell in open sandals drinking gasoline.
Like you said, bring it. You want to bring that heat? I'm in hell with gasoline. Open-toed sandals, what are you going to do? Man. It won't be. Consequences would never be the same. Tom is just like, you know what? I got something for every last one of y'all. You got something to say. You got the heat. I want all that smoke. You don't want it. Tom wants it. And that's how a lot of people should be. Can you handle that smoke? Like, really, if you think of anybody and you have a conversation with them and you guys have a disagreement and you brought some serious heat to that person's way, that person brought that heat back to you. Can you actually, can you really handle that without getting any feelings? Like, somebody could bring heat at me all day long. Will I go off? Probably will. But at the same time, I can handle it because I know how to bring it. I don't care what people say about me, per se, especially when it comes to the internet, like Tom. When it comes to the internet, he knows. I see it all. I'm reading it all. I mean, what? So your internet, you got to have thick skin if you're a reactor, if you're an artist, an entertainer, any of them people. Basically, if your face is in the public view, you got to have thick skin. Somebody bringing something towards you. And at the same time, like myself, I have a more of an unbiased opinion to things. So you could come with me all day with facts and numbers and all that stuff. Tom is saying the same thing. You come at me with whatever. You got to be able to take it. Now, should they shoot back at you, you're not going to win on the internet because you go all day typing up stuff. It does. Nobody wins in the end. You end up looking stupid because I'm going back and forth. Say with one of the jury members, and we're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. What happens? Normally within the first couple of keystrokes, somebody already calls somebody out their name. I don't do it per se because I just try to stay away from that. I just avoid it anyway. I don't do all the name talk. Other people do. What's first? What's the go-to? Racist. What's the go-to? I'm going to come to your house and beat you up. What's the other go-to? You ain't this. You ain't that. You blah, you blah, you blah. I mean, no. And then, what am I supposed to say? Oh, my address is XYZ. Or, okay, I'll meet you outside and fight. Or, no, you this, you race. I mean, nobody wins. It's pretty stupid. Tom is like, you know what? What? Bring it.
And until you smash the screen, like, whoa, I can handle heat. I walk through hell in open sandals drinking gasoline. Yeah. Could have been a star, could have had a mansion and a car and a Grammy album on the charts. I'm a savage, Randy with the bars. I don't rap about
Macho Man Randy Savage. Shout out WWF wrestler, the Macho Man Randy Savage. Brutal rivalry with Hulk Hogan and Elizabeth. Let's go.
Yeah. Could have been a star, could have had a mansion and a car and a Grammy album on the charts. I'm a savage, Randy with the bars. I don't rap about Xanax, goddamn it, can't cancel facts. We need answers, championing track.
Hey, can't cancel facts. We need answers. Facts are subjective to how you bend the numbers, to how you bend your argument. It's facts when you want it to be facts. So you want to cancel facts, especially if you got numbers to back it up. You need answers. You want an answer? I'm going to give it to you. Oh, now you're hating. You don't like that answer. Now you want to argue facts. Now you want to cancel facts because I done destroyed your argument with facts. But you want an answer, I gave it to you, now you hate it. You can't have it both ways, because if you come at me with numbers and facts and all that, I come at you with numbers and facts and all that, people come at each other with numbers and facts and all that, what happened? I'm going to manipulate this to fit my argument. I'm going to manipulate this to fit my argument. Just like the news, just like sports debates, I manipulate the numbers to fit how I need to fit. The other side understands that you got those numbers from somewhere, but they're gonna take their numbers to counterclaim. So why we build somebody up, but then we gotta tear that person down to prop somebody else up? You can't have it both ways. You really can't.
Yeah. Could have been a star, could have had a mansion and a car and a Grammy album on the charts. I'm a savage, Randy with the bars. I don't rap about Xanax, goddamn it, can't cancel facts. We need answers, championing trash to the masses. Actually massively damages, yeah. Keep trying to cancel me, yeah. I own the masters, so yeah. I make the beats, I write the songs, I own the cameras, yeah. I could have been famous.
I own all of it. You want to cancel me? I make the beats. I own the cameras. I write the songs. How you gonna cast me? I own my masters. You know, Prince had a famous line that he always say, but do you own your masters? Because if you're signed to a record label, they own you. You can't even use your own name. That's like if you go to WWE, you leave, that name ain't going with you. You can't use it nowhere else. You better start using your real name. You don't own yourself. I could cancel that artist if I'm the record label. I don't like your music, gone. I could cancel that performer in wrestling if I don't like him. We're just going to retire his name and retire you too. Oh, yeah, if you go to another organization, you still can't use that name. You don't own your name. There's like a record label, like Tom saying, I'm independent. What you going to do? Cancel me? Good luck. Good luck.
Keep trying to cancel me? Yeah. I own the masters, so yeah. I make the beats, I write the songs, I own the cameras, yeah. I could have been famous, dumb my music down till it's basic. Get it on the hottest Spotify playlist. Modify my catalog and go mainstream, yeah.
Tom said, I could sell out to appease people. I'd be on Spotify and all. I'd be on the catalog, water down my music and go mainstream. And who am I going to be? I won't be myself. You got to baby yourself. Be a better you. Baby. Be a better you. Baby. Baby yourself. Like Tom's saying, how am I going to be a better me if I'm being better for them? I'm making them money. I can't be me. I'm only being what they want me to be. Okay, Tom, you got to cut your hair. We may need you to take off some of your face tats. We also need you to wear this type of clothes. Oh, your videos can't be like this. Oh, can we avoid anything political? Because in our building, we have mostly these people. Oh, don't talk about females. Or don't talk about the president or the gay people or any group or the military. Make happy pop music. You know what? We're going to redo your whole image. No. Hell no. Selling out. For who? Why? For what? Come on, Tom. Let's go.
Been famous. Dumb my music down till it's basic. Get it on the hottest Spotify playlist. Modify my catalog and go mainstream. Yeah.
I don't care if you... I'm loving the beat drop because it drops, it goes silent, and just bam. Tom uses his punches and his bars and metaphors to paint the picture. The beat drop is to drive the whole thing home. So when the beat drops and that pause and his chorus come on, it's to drive the point home. So what you going to do? Bang. So it gives you time to think. It's like he frames a question or proposes a question for dialogue at the end of the verse. Let it go silent for a good second and a half, and bam, hit you with the beat drop. I'm back.
Okay, go ahead and change the channel. Don't waste your time trying to cancel me. They love me because they know that I'm in. Say what you want, I guess it is what it is.
You know, with his head wrapped up like that, if you really look at it, it reminds me, if you ever seen that movie, Hellraiser, The Symbiotes? That kind of reminds me of, especially the one that only had the mouth and his eyes was covered up. He reminds me of those dudes from Hellraiser. You see the devil horns? Y'all see the devil horns on that?
I'm trying to cancel me. Okay. They love me because they know that.
On that yellow one? Yeah.
Say what you want. I guess it is what it is. Haters can talk, but they can't cancel the kid.
Like you're saying, say what I want. I guess it is what it is. You don't like it? Hey, it is what it is. Haters, go ahead and keep talking.
Go ahead and go on. Try and say this is it. But I swear to God, you can't cancel the kid.
Like all these rappers lately on a mission. They starting
here we go. Y'all rappers, y'all next. He's calling y'all out next. Y'all got something else to say? Y'all next.
I feel like all these rappers lately on a mission. They starting drama. They don't really want no problems, so they talking whispers. Don't even start, no competition. Y'all are finished. They say they feeling froggy, but I bet none of these frogs gonna rib it.
I bet none of y'all frogs gonna rib it. You talking all that mess. You want drama? Y'all coming out? Y'all really want that? Y'all about that life? It's what Tom's saying. How are you going to cut? Hey, you feeling froggy? I bet none of y'all going to rib it. I really think Tom is, in this video, it reminds me of the Eminem song, I am whatever you say I am. And if I wasn't, then why would I say I am? And that's Tom's response too. I'm all these things, and yet, y'all still click on it. But now you're mad. You want to cancel me. M went through the same thing. Second album, Marshall Mathers. All that stuff. Regardless of how you feel about Marshall, what you think, what he said, but same vibe. I am whatever you say I am. Tom, he's on this trip. Oh, you want to cancel me? There's always a certain rapper that goes to cancel culture. I'm just going to throw out some names. Tupac went through it. M went through it. Tom MacDonald went through it. Anybody that goes against the grain, don't have to be music. Heavy metal, pop, rock, any of them. You go against the grain, here they come out with their pitchforks and torches. They're ready to burn your little house down. The little record label's going to follow suit. You're messing 50 Cent, the biggest troll ever. Oh, you ready to cancel me? Record labels. Well, you know, we got to get rid of you. It's costing us money and they're mad at us. And, you know, well, we got to take you off this movie because you said this on Twitter. So, you know. Come on. Why are so people so dang soft? And this face paint right here reminds me of that movie Dead Presidents. You ever seen the movie Dead Presidents? This way reminds me of, matter of fact, I think it is a nod to Dead Presidents. Just saying. Could be wrong, but that's what I'm thinking. Let's go. Look at the diamond fronts. Come on, Tom.
Start, no competition. Y'all are finished. They say they feeling froggy, but I bet none of these frogs gonna rip it. They think I'm soft, but I promise y'all that I'm solid like a rock inside a Teflon box and dipped in carbon fiber liquid. I'm not religious, but I walk with Christians.
I'm hard than y'all think. Y'all won't jump. Tom saying, I will respond. What you gonna do when I respond? You really don't want...
You don't want that smoke.
You don't. Now, like he's saying, I'm not religious, but I walk with Christians. I'm not religious, but guess what? I do have faith. I have some faith, believe it or not. You may think I'm an atheist, agnostic. You may think whatever you think, but I have faith. No matter what, I still have faith. Come on.
Like a rock inside a Teflon box and dipped in carbon fiber liquid. I'm not religious, but I walk with Christians. If Jesus died for all my sins, he'd need a million crosses tall as buildings. Y'all can't cancel.
What do y'all think about that? He invoked the name of Jesus. Are y'all ready to cancel him now? Are some of y'all ready to cancel him? Because here's what y'all gonna say. He compared himself to Jesus. No, he didn't. It's a metaphor. In this music lane right here, this is how they're treating me. Remember how Jesus was treated? Like this. Look how they treat me. I'm preaching the gospel of my view, as he's saying, of my view. And look what they're doing. They're ready to stone me to death. They're ready to throw me up on the cross. They're ready to just take me out for preaching the truth, for seeing things my way. So he's not comparing himself per se to Jesus. He's just using the metaphor, something, once again, clickbait. Somebody might put that in his title. Somebody might even use that in the title. He compared himself to Jesus. Oh my God. Clickbait. But then they're going to throw that same thing in their title just to get people to clickbait because they're going to use his face to do it. See how that works? I'm hip, Tom. I'm hip. I can listen to that and be like, okay, he ain't comparing to shit. I get what he's saying. That's all you got to do. The minute some people hear a trigger word, they get triggered, they tune out everything else, and they jump right on that train and run with it without really saying, okay, I get what he's saying. He's painting a picture.
If Jesus died for all my sins, he'd need a million crosses tall as buildings.
Because Jesus died for his sins. He's going to need a million crosses because Tom is saying, I'm not perfect. I sin a lot. I've done some things. H.O.G., Hangover Gang, you know what the man did. His life is open. He's an open book. His life is out there on display. He died for my sins. Well, shit, Jesus, you got some work to do, bro. Yeah, I got a lot of them. You better get some more crosses made. There's some wood, some sticks. You better put them together. Get two umbrellas. I don't care. Figure it out. I got a lot of sin. Let's go.
Y'all can't cancel me. I'm a god and you're the devil.
That guitar riff. So he hits the bass kick. That guitar riff come back in. This video is set up where it takes instruments out and put instruments in. It creates the tension. It creates the climax. It creates that. He rides that tension and climax. Because what it does, it holds your attention. So when you listen to the beat holds the attention long enough. His cadence is in there long enough to hold your attention for you to be like, what? What's he going to say? What's he going to say? And when he hits, bam, and then we're all in.
Stop attacking me. Like, whoa, nails in my hands and feet. Y'all some snakes. I don't need fruit from that apple tree.
Nails in my hands and feet. Now, see, once again, people going to say, he ain't Jesus Christ. F him. Cancel him now. Just like this screen. Cancel him now. Y'all some snakes. I don't need fruit from the apple tree. Snakes already out here. The devil's already around my feet. I don't need fruit from that apple tree. Not at all.
Hands and feet. Y'all some snakes. I don't need fruit from that apple tree. I ain't doing features or buying beats. I'm a wolf on light with sheep. I am what I am. And I can't hide my teeth.
Like he's saying, I'm a wolf. I don't need producer. I ain't got to buy my beats. I do everything myself. What I need to be around the sheep for? I'm a wolf. I can't even hide my teeth. You're going to know. You're going to see me snarling. You're going to see. I'm ready to strike at any time. You want it? Let's go. This judge is so far pleased. Let's go.
Sheep, I am what I am, and I can't hide my teeth. Way too many rumors. I'm like, who said it? Never met him. If he dissed me, probably about to drop a new record. I do what I want. Don't matter if I get approval or not. Y'all ain't gonna cyberbully me or try to push on me until I'm becoming some dude who I'm not.
Right there. With that, hey, I do what I want. You ain't gonna cyberbully me till you. Hey, I'm gonna do what I want. You keep bullying me, I'm gonna be somebody that I'm not. I don't get punked on the internet. That's what he's saying. What you gonna punk me on the internet? You think so? Good luck. Cancel culture, and this song is really after cancel culture. Cancel. But he's really after cancel culture. So what he's saying, in a way, is, you know what? Would do something. Half y'all ain't. You just talking. But it's not like he's aware that at some point he may have to watch some of what he said. But I don't think he's too concerned with that right now. He's not doing it to make money. He's not doing this to do that. It's not even so much as creating shockwaves. It's a lot of shockwave, yes, but people triggered, yes, he knows that. But he's also saying, toughen up. Look at everything he's been through, the alcohol, the drugs, the anxiety, depression. You think anything you say this man's going to hurt him? It ain't. It can't do it. So a lot of people been through worse things. So you trying to cancel them or whatever. What can you do? If you've been through a lot of stuff in your life, you think the last thing that's going to hurt you is some words by somebody? When you've been through worse, you probably could have almost died. You probably lost a child, a family member, a loved one, somebody close to you. You could have lost your job and rebounded and got back and been through hell getting that job back and back. And maybe even got to a higher position than where you are now. But you think somebody saying something to you is really going to hurt after a while? Think about that. But some of those same people who've been through a lot of stuff, got back on their feet, all this other good stuff, are some of the most sensitive because now they want to cancel somebody else. So there's a hypocrisy going on as well. So look at both sides of things. That's how it goes.
I do what I want, don't matter if I get approval or not. Y'all ain't gonna cyberbully me or try to push on me until I'm becoming some dude who I'm not. Head full of ludicrous thoughts, producing the songs. My music is truth and you brutally shocked. I'm shooting my shot, I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm New School Pac.
Look at the shout outs. My head is filled with ludicrous thoughts. Shady, Tupac, Biggie. He mentioned four rappers. Ludicrous. Shady, Tupac, Biggie. Hey, what you gonna do? I can speak it however you want to speak it. You know what Pac was about. If you don't know, Pac was like a revolutionary, a very great poet, an orchestrator of words. Biggie, Ready to Die, but can paint vivid pictures with his music. Ludacris, the clown, one of the clown princes of rap, along with M and Redman, and oh man, there's so many others. But those are the three top dogs as far as the clown princes speaking how they want to speak and can paint a picture of some funny things. Then Shady, you know Eminem, you know what he's about. M goes about saying, M, controversial. Tupac, controversial. Biggie, too controversial. Ludacris was somewhat controversial, now known more for the Fast and Furious, but come on.
Trying to push on me until I'm becoming some dude who I'm not. Head full of ludicrous thoughts, producing the songs. My music is truth and you brutally shocked. I'm shooting my shot. I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm new school Pac. Go ahead and call me a piece of garbage, make a starving.
I love that how on that next bar, that bass hits, there's certain bars in there where that bass hits where it needs to be. On the cadence of 1, 2, 3, 4. His beats per minute is out there. But on certain punches and bars, when he hits that bass, hits at the same time. So he gives enough time for the punchline, that bar to hit hard, to drive it home, and it comes with the next one. He's basically machine gunning a lot of people. If you don't know what machine gunning is in rap, is when you just pop, 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 pop. You just blast them. It's like boxing. You just get hit with jabs, crosses, left and right. You can hit with combinations. And he's hitting a lot of combos in his bars. His wordplay so far is tremendous. And this song is tremendous.
Head full of ludicrous thoughts, producing the songs. My music is truth and you brutally shocked. I'm shooting my shot. I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm new school Pac. Go ahead and call me a piece of garbage. Make a starving artist your primary target. I'm the largest...
Go ahead, make this starving artist your primary target. You know what a starving artist is? A lot of people who do a lot of paintings and artworks and really not getting paid for it. So he's saying, go ahead, I'm a starving artist. I'm trying to get paid. I'm trying to make money. You want to keep bring it. I don't care. I'm trying to create art, imagery, for y'all people to understand. I'm all about that. Come on.
My music is truth and you brutally shocked. I'm shooting my shot. I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm new school Pac. Go ahead and call me a piece of garbage. Make a starving artist your primary target. I'm the largest monster in the farthest darkness. I'm a claws are sharpened. I'm an army sergeant. If people...
I'm the largest monster in the farthest darkest. My claws are sharpened. I'm an army sergeant. You see the way he used that R, R, R. That hit home. Not to mention if he painted another picture again. I'm the biggest monster in the farthest darkness. My claws are sharpened. He's spitting some truth to what he thinks. Claws are sharpened. Come on, Army Sergeant, R, Sar, Far, Dark, Claws, Sharp. He's using that long AR. That wordplay was phenomenal.
Push on me until I'm becoming some dude who I'm not. Head full of ludicrous thoughts, producing the songs. My music is truth and you brutally shocked. I'm shooting my shot, I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm new school Pac. Go ahead and call me a piece of garbage. Make a starving artist your primary target. I'm the largest monster in the farthest darkness. My claws are sharpened. I'm an army sergeant.
If people... Now, if you use da 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 da, even the pot, the ludicrous thoughts, da 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 da, then he switched the cadence up to the far da 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 da. That wordplay was nice.
Well, look at my face, embrace, I'm unstable. I ain't gonna break or shake or feel shameful.
Like I said, you ain't gonna make me break or feel shameful. I ain't gonna be ashamed of nothing I did. Think you're gonna make or break me? You think you're gonna do that to me?
I'm Biggie, I'm Shady, I'm new school Pac. Go ahead and call me a piece of garbage. Make a starving artist your primary target. I'm the largest monster in the farthest darkness. My claws are sharpened. I'm an army sergeant. If people wanna hate, then I'm grateful. It's only gonna make what I say.
See? You wanna hate, then I'm grateful. That means you're paying attention to me. If you want to hate, I'm grateful. I love haters. Hell, I do too. You need haters sometime. Cat Williams said that too. If you ain't got haters, you got 10, you need 25. You got 30, you need 50. So like you said, if I got haters, I'm good. That means I'm doing something right or I said something that touched the nerve. I got your attention.
I hate that I'm grateful. It's only going to make what I say less painful. Look up.
See? Only going to make what I say less painful. Because you already hating. So when I say this, it ain't gonna hurt. Guess what? When I say this, it's gonna be less painful for you. Less painful for me, too. That's what he's saying. You, me, hey, we win.
Look at my face, embrace, I'm unstable. I ain't gonna break or shake or feel shameful.
I don't care if you mad at me, okay? Go ahead and change the channel. No wasting time trying to cancel me, okay?
you want, I guess it is what it is. Haters can talk, but they can't cancel the kid. Go ahead and go on, try and say this is it. But I swear to God, you can't cancel the kid.
Tom MacDonald does it again, and he drops another one. And guess what? He had a lot to say to some of y'all haters. He don't care. Type what you want in the comments. He's trash. He's weak. He's blah. Whatever. Verdict right after this. Guess what? That was Tom MacDonald. All right, let's get it. Bars had bars for days. Every line had a meaning. Nothing wasted. The punches was great. He used the wordplay stupendously. The wordplay was nice. He used multi-syllable tactics on that. Bars. Flow. Cadence switch. Four times. The scene song on the hook. The cadence flow. Slow down. Up-tempo preaching. Well, low-tempo basically preaching. Before the even guitar riff comes in, more of the orchestra, like a choir, but the Ministry of Darkness just coming in, the druid sound, them druids coming in. Message, it was clear. Fuck y'all haters. Don't care about cancel culture. Bring it. I'm paid. I'm rich. Whatever you say don't hurt. My skin is made out of Teflon. Crime scene. You had the cage. You try and lock him in the cage. Red lights. Basically, he's locked away. Key thrown away. Red dots on the shirt with the target on it. Take your best shot. I'm right here. You want to cancel me? You're going to have to take me out. Bars, flow, message, crime scene. Dope. The man got it. And earns himself a hard-to-get Black Rose from me. So you get the Black Rose premeditated worder, not to mention... He talked his shit and called a lot of people out. So that also means voluntary manslaughter. Lock this man up in solitary confinement. Man, life behind bars. Once again, Tom MacDonald. Cancel. This is a Kane. This face famous. Shh. You see it?